Hi everyone. So today we're taking a look at a new launcher that's come onto the market. This is SF launcher. It's in alpha currently. If you're not familiar with software releases, an alpha basically means that the software is very, very early stages. It's a concept in some respects. The developer is just trying this out to see how people react to it. Next up will be a beta. More bug fixes and so on, maybe some new features, and then a final release. But there's a lot here to really, really like in the approach. So this is basically what you see. Your launcher has this option up at the top, which is your clock, but also gives you quick access to Google Now. If you set up the long presses on there, you've got options to basically set how it will react to various taps and so on, making it quite a nice functional area as well as looking quite pretty. You can control what graphic appears in there. This is your widget area, and so you add a widget. Let's just add a calendar, and then you can swipe between it for your widget areas. Now, as you can see there, you also, if you swipe all the way over, this is where your app tray is, and you can move these applications into this area at the bottom here, which is effectively a quick launch area. So everything's kept fairly contained. You don't get loads and loads of home screens, but everything kind of just works. Very fluid. I mean, for an alpha, I could find very few things wrong with this, put it that way. If you want to scroll through all of your apps, you can. If you want to add an application onto your quick bar, you add it to favorites. And then it becomes available there. If you swipe all the way over to this side, you get into the menu options. So you can then control how this particular launcher is going to operate. You can control the particular header as well. San Francisco and London being the ones available at the moment. What time dusk and daylight start and night start just changes how the image is going to be displayed. Clock long press action, so what will it do when you long press or just quick tap? The widgets and how that widget area is going to actually react, which is not working at the moment. Favorites, which actually controls basically how many columns you will have and the icon size. So there's a lot of flexibility here. And then you've got the app list, which is your main app drawer, really. But for a kind of concept launcher, for an alpha as well, it's very, very slickly done. And it works quite nicely. I've been using it for a couple of days and found it to be, well, exactly as described, a launcher. And one that works exceptionally well. It's up on the Play Store now as a test, so anyone can have a bit of a go with it. I'd certainly recommend you check it out and see what you think yourself. This is SF Launcher.